giving you an opportunity to get the full story from the people who tell it best. This is MediaCom News Leaders.
I'm Elizabeth Kling with MediaCom News Leaders. Thousands of families in the metro will face food insecurity this month alone. And that's a problem that the Des Moines Area Religious Council is working to solve. And here to tell us more about their work is Matt Unger, DMARC's CEO. Thank you for coming in.
Thanks for having me.
So let's talk about just the organization as a whole and the work that DMARC does in our community.
Sure. So we're based on this foundation of interfaith cooperation, which I think particularly in today's environment, having a variety of faiths cooperating to meet a common goal, we like to lead the way in that way. Yeah. But so what we do primarily to focus on meeting human needs is our network of 14 pantries throughout the metro area and the 29 mobile pantries that we put out to serve the folks who need a little food that maybe don't have enough to make what they need on their table for them and their families.
Yeah, let's talk about what hunger looks like in our community, because I think sometimes maybe people have sort of a preconceived notion of who families are or who people are that need food pantries.
Sure.
And that may not be accurate, I guess.
Absolutely. So it doesn't look a lot different than you or I. I think a lot of folks have this misconception that the only folks facing hunger in our community are those who are also facing homeless and some of the other hard to deal with issues. And there's a portion of folks who are in that category. But largely, you know, it's families, it's working folks. Maybe someone had a good job and now since the recession they've had two jobs and they're not making what they were making before to make ends meet. You know, struggling with a healthcare issue that pops up or something big. So it's families, all races, kind of moderate to low income folks. Sometimes folks with means, you know, come in and out of needing a little bit of help with food once in a while.
Right, and when people come in and say, listen, you know, I need a little help this month, how does that process work? Because some people might be pretty self-conscious about doing that.
Sure. So at any of our metro pantries, folks come in, we have an intake process to try to understand what some of the other issues they might be facing are, because we want to help them to
line them up with the other services
that they might need as well. But yeah, they come in, they go through an intake process, and then at any of our pantries, you're guaranteed a 3-day supply of food for you and your family, based on your family's size. And then they can come back for some things that we, you know, the perishable items that maybe we don't want to hold for 1 month distribution, that they can come and get those anytime as we have them, and some of the food that we're rescuing throughout the community that would otherwise be
food that you're rescuing. Tell us more about that.
So, you know, retailers, some other producers, they'll have leftover foods that otherwise might be going into the trash, and we do our best to make sure we can rescue those foods and get them to folks who could really use them before they are bad and need to be thrown out.
And you have a special focus on providing healthy food.
We do. So we did a study with Iowa State several years ago that showed our pantry visitors faced a much higher incidence of diabetes than the normal population. So we didn't want to contribute to additional problems that we knew a lot of the folks we were facing were having. So we focus on produce, on really healthy items. We have an innovative sort of system called Pantry 2.0, where instead of having folks choose items off a shelf out of categories, they get a number of points. And everything in the pantry will be scored based on its nutritional value. Uh-huh. So the lower point items are the better for you items and vice versa.
Sure.
And so it kind of incentivizes making healthy choices to bring more home for your family.
Yeah. So tell us about then what's ahead for DMARC as you're working to sort of have these innovative ideas to help people connect with the food that they need and the services they need. What's next for you?
Well, we are out of space. So the big thing coming up for us is looking for a new location. And we're getting down the road on that. And we'll be coming out to the community for support for a big project in that way as well. But with the growth in the folks that we're serving, we've been seeing between 5 and 10% growth each month over the prior year. We're out of space, so we're looking for new ways to innovate, new ways we can look at data and come up with new interventions that'll help not just hunger needs, but kind of all the symptoms of poverty, if you will, working together with other partners and other nonprofit organizations to try to help out and build up our community and get those without a little bit more.
And if people are seeing this and say, this is something I want to be a part of. How can I help? What
should
they
well,
do?
Of course, as any nonprofit organization, we thrive and we exist on the donations of those who support us. So financial contributions are paramount. But also food drives. If you can do a food drive at your company or your church or an organization that you belong to, come volunteer for our organization. We have a lot of different volunteer opportunities that people can access at our website. You know, having that extra help goes a long way too.
Sure does. Well, thanks so much for your time today.
Absolutely.
We appreciate
thanks, Elizabeth.
We've been talking with Matt Unger, the CEO of DMARC. Join us next time here on MediaCom News Leaders.